But thanks everyone for joining. It looks like we have a great group today. We want to run through, hopefully everyone can see the presentation now. We want to run through just some of the kind of 2014 highlights from the marketing perspective, as well as preview some of the plans that we're working on for 2015. So we can get you guys engaged and start to get input on that, and hopefully we can all be aligned as we are marketing around OpenStack this year. So any questions up front? Otherwise, we'll just dive into 2014. Good deal. So just really quick, we'll run through some metrics and highlights from 2014. First of all, the summits, of course, which are a major part of what we do, and have been, hopefully you feel they've been hugely successful. They definitely have been from a metrics perspective, as well as some of the big case studies that we had this year, which was, you know, a huge focus for us, was getting out the voice of the user, and especially elevating some major brands and enterprises that are using OpenStack. And finally, we'll look through a few of the metrics that we've been capturing over the last year, and which hopefully you will find interesting. So first of all, this is just a quick snapshot of the Atlanta Summit. It was a really large summit for us, a big jump. The previous one was in Hong Kong in October of 2013, and so 6 months later, we grew by 1,500 attendees. We had a great attendance from press and analysts as well. And I think, you know, some of the really cool things were having Wells Fargo and Disney and Sony and some really big users come speak at the event. It's where we launched that super user campaign, and I feel like we made a lot of traction on the user front. So I just thought this would be interesting for you guys to get a quick snapshot of some of the metrics from that event. And then jumping over the same thing that we have for Paris. I think the important thing to call out here is just, you know, the reason why we move these summits around, and you know, we brought them to Asia, and Paris was our first summit in Europe, is you can see the attendees by region, that we had 47% that attended from Europe, which is, you know, a huge jump from what we had in Atlanta, and it really makes the summit and the community accessible to more people around the world. So that's pretty exciting for me to see. And also, Paris turned out to be much larger than we expected and planned for, just based on kind of, you know, the trend, well, not really much of a trend, but the one data point of going to Hong Kong, and, you know, we didn't see the huge attendance jump from Portland the previous summit. We were planning for Paris to actually be a little bit smaller than Atlanta was, or definitely not to grow since Atlanta had grown so much. So we were really surprised, and also it's a great thing to see that, you know, how many attendees we had in Paris. If you look around at other industry events like, I believe, the Gartner Symposium that they do in Europe, or even, you know, VMworld Europe, we're really about the same size. I mean, we're looking at the same venues that they are as we're planning out future summits. It's pretty incredible how quickly we've gotten there. So thank you all for your support of both of the summits. Just wanted to share these snapshots and hope you find them interesting as well. Just quickly, last year we launched Super User Magazine, which if you guys haven't checked it out, it's superuser.openstack.org. It's something we kind of soft launched at the Atlanta Summit and really worked to build up a good base of content last year. And this year, we'll talk about this a little bit later in the presentation, but this year we're really wanting to focus more resources on it and drive more traffic, and I think we really have a great foundation there and a lot of good content and user stories. But you can see a list here of some of the users that we launched last year, whether we worked with them to speak or do a keynote at the different summits, or if we put together case study campaigns, or through the super user publication. We really put a lot of effort into case studies and user stories last year, and hopefully that has paid off and been felt by you guys as well. Another thing that we did last year, hopefully you have noticed, we gave OpenStack.org an update, a new look and feel. It started in October. We redid the homepage, and we also brought that look and feel to the automaker campaign. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed the new site. We're always interested in getting feedback, and we have a lot of plans to continue rolling out updates there this year as well. So I think it really looks much more polished. We're trying to put more user content front and center. I think it looks nice, but just wanted to make sure you guys are all aware. Last year, also in Atlanta, we launched the OpenStack Marketplace, which, you know, from our perspective, it really gives us a great call to action with the traffic that we're getting to our website and through our different campaigns, so that we can push people into the ecosystem to help, you know, whether they want to adopt OpenStack or get training or look into different ways to use it. So it's been very successful from our perspective. We're really excited with the different products and services we've been able to have listed in there. We added a category in August after we launched the marketplace, and in May we added the hosted private cloud category because it's a section that, or rather a market that we saw really take off last year, and we've had some really strong traffic. And the last bullet on this slide is just to mention that after we did the homepage redesign in October and made the marketplace more prominent, we've also seen more traffic go there since then. So if you have a product that fits within one of these categories and, you know, meets our technical requirements in terms of including OpenStack code or supporting the APIs, definitely contact us to make sure that we have you listed and included in this marketplace. And then we'll also be talking about some additional enhancements and new categories that we're considering and working on for this year. So hopefully if there's not a perfect category for you there right now, there will be over the course of this year. And finally, one campaign that we launched last year, I believe this was August actually, is a white paper about a top 10 automaker that was using OpenStack for a big data analytics case study. So we really put a lot of effort into it was one of the first case studies where we had some really great metrics in terms of performance, in terms of ROI and results with OpenStack. So we put a lot of effort into building out this white paper. Kathy Cacciatore from our team worked with Seth Fox at Selenia because it was one of their users to build this out, and we created a landing page for it and did an integrated campaign around it. And it was really the first one that we've done like that, and we found a lot of success. So it's something that we are continuing into 2015 with some additional campaigns that we'll talk about a little bit later. But I just wanted to share this with everyone, and also just a great, you know, call out for Selenia, who brought us this customer, and then we were able to, you know, promote them through this page as well. So if you have any great customer stories, especially those that, you know, really share, can have some of these, you know, ROI performance type metrics, we're definitely interested in them. And finally, just a little update on our metrics over the year. You're more than welcome to go back and take a closer look at these slides or ask us any questions, but we just wanted to share what we're seeing in terms of website traffic as well as across our different social media channels, because we probably know we hired Allison Price last year, I guess it was last March, and she's been putting a lot of effort into this into social media as well as into driving traffic to our website. So we've seen some great results from it, and just wanted to share some of that work that we've been doing. So that's really it for 2014. Are there any questions or any thoughts that people have?
No questions. Good progress, though.
Awesome. Thank you.
Yeah, quite a successful year, I think. This is Derek.
Well, thank you all. Obviously, everything that we do is very much extended and supported by the community, so it's been a really, really great community and great to see it grow this last year. So we'll switch gears. And before we get into some of the more I just wanted to share a little bit of context of the community overall and some of the big initiatives the board and the staff are focused on. And I think that maybe someone went off mute. There's a little feedback right now on the line. Did everyone mute their lines unless they have a question? Okay. Awesome. So just for a little context again, I want to make sure everyone's aware of some of these broader initiatives. Okay. Please mute your line if you're not your question. So in 2014, the Board of Directors created the DAC Core Committee. And
that's not me, by the way. This is Derek who spoke. I've been on mute, but whoever spoke before me, maybe you could go back on mute.
I was on mute as well.
Sorry.
Okay.
I can mute everything, and then I'll just unmute it when you ask the questions that you're just trying to
do. You are now muted.
All right. So just for a little context again, so the Board of Directors created the DEF Core Committee, which was actually kind of further down the line from some previous committees and initiatives, but they were really tasked with defining a core set of capabilities, which can be tested, as well as a designated sections of code that need to be included in any downstream product that wants to brand itself as OpenStack. And this is, you know, really important because it's about tightening up what that core set of services needs to be, whether you're, you know, an OpenStack public cloud or private cloud service or a solution, we're trying to establish a baseline layer of interoperability or compatibility. So this was an important initiative last year, and the Board of Directors got through, they basically set the capabilities and the designated sections and had the board approve that for the Havana release, which I know at this point is getting a little bit dated, but it was kind of the biggest hurdle to get through the first one. And then after Havana, it's really just kind of adding pieces, a little bit of pieces for each release. So the Board of Directors set that policy, and in 2015, the foundation staff is really focused on implementing that. So we are working on building out a product testing program and how we will, you know, expose those test results, as well as how those test results feed into, you know, the OpenStack commercial logos that we have. So, you know, in order for a product or a cloud to be branded as OpenStack powered, they need to have passed those tests, and they need to, you know, include those designated sections of code. So you know, we're still relatively early days for this, but I think it's really important because it's going to be a big initiative for us at the foundation this year in terms of, you know, operationally putting this program together, coming up with the workflow for that, as well as communicating that to the market and, you know, the value of all, you know, all of these different OpenStack products running this common set of services and being compatible. So, again, just setting up that context before we kind of dive into the plans for this year. At the same time, if you think about what the Board of Directors has done, it's kind of on the downstream side. The technical committee has also started examining the scope of OpenStack from an upstream perspective in terms of what they package as the integrated release and, you know, the coordinated release that goes out every 6 months. You know, it's definitely been expanding in scope over the last year. And there have been some proposals, although it's definitely very early days and nothing is set in stone at this point. There's another discussion this afternoon in the technical committee meeting about moving from what is now considered the integrated release to a different classification system that would actually create kind of a smaller, you know, ideally more stable core set of services with a larger ecosystem around it. And we'll go into more details in a little bit later in this presentation, but this is also just another big change that's happening in the community that is really important for us to be involved in and consider, and will have a lot of implications for the marketing team. Another piece is just, you know, last year, and even after the Atlanta Summit, I feel like we still had the question from press and analysts of, you know, where are the users? It doesn't seem like major enterprises are using OpenStack. It doesn't seem like the users are out there. And while, you know, of course, there's still a search for production of deployments, meaning a certain, I guess, percentage of our deployments being production, I think that we've finally moved past that question of just where are the users. We've gotten enough really great case studies out there over this last year. And now we're getting into, you know, more in depth of what are people really doing with it? What workloads are they running? What are the reference architectures? People are going to the next level, which is really exciting and presents a lot of opportunity for us this year. And finally, you know, last year we really focused on the operator community, and not operator like telco, but more operator like running these OpenStack clouds. We built up the operators mailing list. We launched the operator summits, which we had two kind of mid-cycle summits for that, as well as more dedicated events at the main OpenStack summit. And you know, we've seen the huge growth in this community, a lot of engagement, and really seen them start to influence the projects and the direction of the software, which has been great. And again, you know, we've started to be able to expose a lot of those case studies as well. So, you know, as we're looking and making plans for 2015, the next frontier for us is really that, you know, next level user. A lot of these folks who have built clouds and are now that we have this footprint, they're asking, you know, how do they get their internal development team to adopt their OpenStack cloud infrastructure, and how do we make, you know, the OpenStack APIs an attractive target for these developers. So so again, just kind of going to the next level up, thinking a lot more about workloads and applications. Cool. Any questions? Or? Awesome. So that's just kind of some context. I wanted to make sure everyone was on the same page and knew some things that were going on in the community. So just as we're kind of thinking of what's next for OpenStack and what we're focused on this year, again, it's with all the initiatives around DevCore and even around tightening the integrated release, it's really coming up with that kind of smaller, stable target that can provide a solid platform across these different OpenStack cloud deployments. So in other words, 2015 is the year of interop for us. So it's not, interop isn't necessarily our, you know, external message in terms of benefit to users, but it's definitely a theme across everything that we're doing, not just from a marketing perspective, of course, you know, across the foundation and community as a whole. So so just with that in mind, as we take a look at what we see as our kind of big marketing initiatives this year, they really all run under this larger interop theme. So any questions there so far? Cool. So the three big initiatives that we are, you know, focused on, and we'll go into more detail around each of these, but the first one is, you know, demonstrating that value of this global network of public and private clouds that are running OpenStack. And, you know, now that we have this much tighter definition of OpenStack in terms of this, you know, core set of capabilities and services, it's something that we really want to promote. So that's the first piece of it. The second is, I mentioned this proposal from the technical committee in terms of, you know, how we're evolving the integrated release as well as some of the changes with DevCore. But I think it's going to be really important how we help communicate this to users in the community this year. So this is a major focus for us as well. And then finally, talking about that next level user, it's OpenStack, now that we have a more defined target, positioning it as the best platform for building and running applications. Sorry, I was just looking at Laura's question. It says, does interop refer to the word interoperability? In Cisco's world, this refers to the big networking conference. Yes, that's right. It refers to interoperability, not the conference in this case. So those are our three big areas, and then I'll dive into a little bit of detail underneath each of those. So the first one is just the global network of cloud deployments. So, you know, this is just a huge competitive advantage for OpenStack, having this, you know, common set of services and APIs that can be run internally as well as with public clouds and other services. So, again, communicating the implementation of set core policy and product testing, but, you know, really taking that to the external market and the benefits to users of when they're looking for OpenStack branded solutions, what does that mean? You know, what services can they count on to be there, and what does that mean for them in terms of, you know, workload portability and choice of vendors around the world. So this will be a big focus for us this year, and we'll be launching some of those new programs and including that in a lot of our messaging that we're working on. Also, as I mentioned, we're going to be working on the marketplace and evolving that to expose these test results and focus on that, as well as expand some different sections. And we'll be putting a lot of juice behind marketplace promotion this year across all of our campaigns and just paid advertising as well. We are working on a demonstration, well, potentially, but we're working hard to make it happen, on a demonstration for the Vancouver Summit demonstrating workload federation across public and private clouds. So we're really excited about that, and we'll also be working on different case studies that support this message. The second piece was, you know, just helping to communicate the evolution of the integrated release. And I'll go into a little more detail about that on the next slide. But I do think it's just, you know, a huge opportunity for us from a marketing perspective to talk about the, you know, that smaller, tighter, stable core of services, as well as highlight some of the innovation in the ecosystem with different projects around it. And then finally, it's just, you know, we really started last year to position OpenStack as the center of cloud innovation. And part of that is with the OpenStack architecture being very pluggable and supporting a diverse set of technologies, especially on the enterprise front, support for different enterprise technologies, and being well positioned to capitalize on emerging technologies, like, of course, support for Docker and just, you know, the way that OpenStack is built and the way that different communities can get involved. It really becomes that you know, framework and platform that helps to manage all of these different technologies. So that's the second piece. And I'll go into kind of a side note, a little more detail about the evolution of the integrated software release, because I just want to make sure that everyone is on the same page about what's happening, and I want to make, it's something that we're monitoring very closely and want to influence and be a part of, so I just want to make sure everyone has the current information, and also very much with the caveat that that all of this is continuing to change and evolve, of course. It's, you know, an open source community. These proposals are out in public, and they're being discussed at the different technical committee meetings, but it is by no means set in stone yet, so I'm just kind of giving you the current state of affairs. But you may have heard toward the end of last year there were some different proposals and blog posts about the big tent, which was basically letting more projects become official OpenStack projects. And I regret that it was called the big tent, because I think that that concept scared a lot of people, and they were thinking, oh, that means every project that's in StackForge is just suddenly going to become an OpenStack project. And, you know, we were already having issues with the expansion of scope, and we want more stability, and we want a smaller core. And this seems totally counter to what, you know, users have been asking for. So, you know, of course, things have evolved a lot since then, but I put the artist formerly known as the Big Tent, because this name is still kind of stuck around, but I really don't think it's a great representation for the what's currently being discussed. So basically, the technical committee is considering moving to this tag system, which would, you know, really be more sophisticated way of identifying and communicating around different projects. So rather than it being, you know, this larger integrated release that you're either in or you're incubated or you're out, and it's this very kind of linear model, it would be applying, you know, hopefully, this is definitely not, the types of tags have not been decided on yet, but hopefully more helpful guidance for users that, you know, might want to adopt a different project if, you know, how does it scale, the level of maturity, does it have documentation support, is it supported by the security team, is it part of the stable branch? So just kind of providing more helpful detail there. And also as part of this, we effectively be pairing back what the integrated release is now to a more kind of stable core set of services that we can really focus on, which very much I believe with, you know, current proposals would align with what DefCore has outlined for the downstream products. And then it would also give us an opportunity to recognize a lot of the innovation that's happening in the community, which is, you know, also very important as, you know, Amazon and Google and others continue to innovate. You know, it's really important for us to be able to showcase what's happening in the OpenStack community on that front. So I think that this really gives us a large opportunity from a marketing standpoint, but if what the current proposal is goes through, it would definitely, you know, impact us a lot in terms of how we communicate around OpenStack, especially in regards to integrated release and different projects. So Kilo will, right now the idea is that Kilo will basically be the last integrated release. And then after that, we'll continue to have kind of these named design cycles, or development cycles. So there will still be an L cycle, and then, you know, followed by an M cycle and so on, but there won't necessarily be an L integrated release of services. There'll still be a coordinated release, but it'll be smaller, and it won't be like the one big flashpoint that we have right now with the integrated release. So it may be that we, you know, will actually have the opportunity to talk about different projects more often, because there's a lot of stuff that goes in the integrated release right now, and it'll give us a chance to kind of spread that out and go more in depth on what's happening across different projects. It also will definitely change, you know, how we're referring to the release and everything else. I mean, we probably need to build out a glossary if these different changes go through. So, again, I just, you know, it's somewhat complex, but I just wanted everyone to be aware of the conversations that are happening, and especially if you've heard the term big tent and feel a little scared by what that means, I wanted to allay some fears there. And, you know, basically that I think it's a really great opportunity for us to focus on this solid, stable core while balancing that with the innovation that's happening. So, anyway, I will take it off mute really fast because I muted it before the line and see if anyone has questions, or feel free to jump in if you have any additional thoughts about what's going on.
You are now unmuted.
Has anyone heard about this?
Sorry, heard about what? Heard about Big Ten?
Yeah, I heard about basically the evolution of the integrated release, how the project would be classified.
Deshaun, no, I had not heard about
this. Okay.
Yeah, and yeah, I mean, this is Derek from Intel. I mean, sure, we're clearly involved in those discussions, and interesting to observe how, and you know, how that's going to affect the marketing. So.
Yeah, and it's, you know, it's one of those interesting challenges with open source marketing where it's not like you can just figure it all out internally and launch it one day, because, you know, people are having conversations in public as this evolves, and there's kind of some version control issues there, but we're definitely, you know, very involved and want to be on top of it, and we'll be sharing more with this group as it goes along, and definitely, you know, want to hear any perspective you guys have on it as well.
Oh, this is a good overview, though. Appreciate the details for this group.
Cool. All right. Well, I have some more pieces to go through. I'm going to mute the line again because
you are now muted.
Take off the background noise. Sorry about that. So finally, the third piece, going back to the three big initiatives that we had, was building on OpenStack. So again, this is where we're really laying the foundation this year. If you think about the work that we did last year of building up the operators community, establishing that mailing list, working on more case studies, the different events that we had for operators, we're really kind of looking at the same playbook for that for application teams. So there's a couple of different working groups that are relevant for this, the Application Ecosystem Working Group and the API Working Group. The former brainstormed at the Paris Summit tackling or building a reference app to run on OpenStack and using that as the basis for some documentation, which we desperately need, which will also help us in terms of building out collateral and having a really good call to action for this audience. So that's some of the work that I expect to see happening the first half of this year. And I think that, we'll really shift and start to focus on this probably post-Vancouver in terms of, building out more material on the OpenStack.org website and possibly sponsoring or attending a few different industry events and just trying to build out our different content and materials. So I wanted to give everyone a heads up on that. Good deal. So I'll run through, those are kind of the higher level pieces. I'm just going to run through some of the tactics, I suppose, and I'll try to do this quickly so that we can get to other questions and feedback. And of course, it's all in the slides, and you guys can reach out to us if you have any questions. The first main thing, and I know that we did a whole webinar dedicated to this a few weeks ago, so we won't go into too much detail, but for the Vancouver Summit, which is happening May 18th through 22nd, registration is live. Tomorrow is a big deadline for sponsors. The sponsor contract will go online at 9 a.m. Pacific, 11 a.m. Central. And then speaking submissions are due February 9th. So those are just the big upcoming deadlines. I'm sure all you guys are involved in working on it, and thank you as always for your support. Sorry. There. And then just a heads up, Tokyo is October 26th through 29th, and we are actually working on an early prospectus for that and trying to get that process moving a little more quickly, ideally before even the Vancouver Summit. So more on that to come soon. So a little kind of overview about our industry events and how we have participated. Many of you may have worked with Kathy Cacciatore, who helped organize our kind of sponsorships and presence at different industry events. And sometimes we would have just an OpenStack booth, and we would get volunteers from different organizations in the ecosystem or users to come help staff it and talk about OpenStack. And sometimes we would actually host a pavilion, and we would have different companies in the ecosystem with kiosks in the pavilion. We're starting to slow down our investment and participation in these industry events. We really see our role at the foundation as that kind of awareness, very top of the funnel, if you want to think about it that way, role. At this point, when we're going to a lot of these events, we really just need to pass someone off to an ecosystem company to be able to get what they need and take the next steps with OpenStack. They're usually already aware, and they may be interested, or they may have some specific questions to make sure if it's their use case, but really it requires that kind of next step. So you can take a look at the sponsorships that we have listed for this year, and these are kind of our final plans, and then starting in next year, we'll really be winding a lot of these down. I think moving forward, the reasons we would have to, invest in a larger sponsorship or go to a show would be if we're taking on new markets, for example, really going after the application developers, or if there's a specific vertical where it makes sense, or if it's, you know, there's a regional reason. But as far as just kind of like primary North America trade shows, we're really going to be rolling out of those. But instead, what we'd like to do and where we'd like to focus our investment and effort is enabling the different companies who are already exhibiting at these shows with, you know, OpenStack collateral and, you know, signage or giveaways and talking points and basically creating different kits for companies in our ecosystem who may be going to different shows to create an OpenStack presence on the floor and make sure that the OpenStack brand is getting out there without us not necessarily having a direct sponsorship. So just wanted to give everyone a heads up about our thinking around that as we start to kind of wind that down over the next year. And then finally, just wanted to talk a little about OpenStack Days, and we can go into more detail on this later in the year. But we've found these events to be extremely successful around the world. Usually these are kind of one-day events that are hosted by local user group leaders that attract, you know, anywhere between 200 to 1,000 plus people. And, you know, they can be more focused sessions with regional users or kind of specific requirements or topics of interest for that region or vertical. So we started to see that kind of expand last year, and some different organizations throw events under our event policy that were branded with OpenStack, but became kind of confusing to people in the community or, you know, potential attendees because they thought they were being organized by the OpenStack Foundation when they weren't necessarily, and they didn't feel like entirely community events. So we are, one of the things that we want to focus on this year and work on is evolving that kind of event policy and guidelines for these community events and really just making them more kind of templatized and providing more resources, whether that's, you know, logos to signage and giveaways and the speakers bureau and all the different pieces that they need to put together these events, but making them a bit more prescriptive and templatized rather than and, you know, consistent with our kind of branding and community philosophy. So if you are interested in getting involved with that, I would contact Claire and Shari. They're going to be working on putting together that program. It'll probably take us, you know, a few months, and we'll be working on the different community mailing lists with just kind of our different ideas and thoughts about evolving the guidelines. But again, just wanted to give everyone a heads up of something we're going to be working on this year. And so those were the different events that we had going on this year. I just wanted to run through a few of the different campaigns that we're working on as well. The first one is an integrated campaign series, which I'll go into a little more detail about, but really just following on the efforts and success around the top 10 automaker white paper and evolving that in doing a series this year of regular white papers and integrated campaigns. So I'll go into a little more detail in just a moment. Second, I just wanted to give a heads up that we're interested in working with the analyst relations team on commissioning a market share adoption report for OpenStack. We started engaging with the 451 group in IDC toward the end of last year about scoping this project, and it's something that we're hoping to get off the ground in the next, or ideally in Q1. So if you're interested in being a part of that, definitely pay attention to the analyst relations team and get involved there, because we'd love some participation from the community. The third thing is Super User Magazine, which I mentioned earlier. We kind of did a soft launch for it last May, and we've really built out some great content. I encourage you to go check out the site if you haven't seen it. And we're always looking for case studies and topic ideas there as well. But we've changed up the resources on that a little bit, brought in a journalist to help us really take it to the next level this year. So hopefully it'll be more prominent and you guys will want to get involved. I think this is the main thing to call out on this page. I'll just jump over to integrated campaigns. I'm sure that Kathy's on the call, but I may not unmute it right now just to avoid the line interference. But last year we launched that top 10 automaker case study, and it was under openstack.org/enterprise. And this year we're looking to really build out that section with not only additional case studies, but really grouping them by workload and kind of a package of materials, whether it's white paper and reference architectures and relevant videos from different summit presentations that all kind of tie together with these different topics. And you can see what were the topics that we're exploring in the last bullet as well. Kathy Cacciatore is really taking the lead on building out this content, and as well working with Allison on the campaigns around this on our team. So if you have ideas or feedback on the topics as well as ideas of different users, please do get involved. And on that note, I just wanted to make sure that everyone knew who the foundation marketing team was. And just in terms of points of contact, obviously the foundation team is much larger, but probably relevant points of contact for this group and our email addresses and the different pieces that we work on. I'm sure most of you are familiar with Claire for the summit. She's probably the most popular person on staff. And then we have Allison, who's really focused on social media and case studies and content. Shari, who really supports Claire on the summits and global events. And then Kathy, who you may have worked with previously on different industry events, sponsorships. She's really shifting her role this year and going to be focused on those on content and those integrated campaigns. And she's also been really involved with the Win the Enterprise team and is our kind of liaison there as well. So some different points of contact for our team. Just thought it might be helpful to refresh for everyone. As well as our extended team, we work with some outside firms for media and analyst relations support. So I just wanted everyone to be aware of who we work with and have some contact information to reach out. So Robert Caffey with Caffey Communications does our US PR AR, and his information is there as well. So if you are doing a press release or need some help on the media analyst front, he is your person to go to. And he and Allison will also be hosting the next marketing meeting in February, where they're going to go into more detail around a new news page that we're launching and just kind of how to engage with us to support your different launches and media activities. And he'll be focused on that side, and Allison will be providing some information around our social media channels and kind of companies in the ecosystem to best promote what you're doing. So if you're interested in those topics, definitely attend the meeting in February. Super User Magazine, I mentioned. The people that are involved there, Nicole is the journalist I mentioned that we brought in, and then Joan Stillworth is an agency we've worked with for a while that helped us build and launch the publication. So you can reach them at editor@superuser.org. And then finally, the logo programs and trademarks. If you're branding your product and you might be submitting some information, Lisa Miller is our legal counsel and support on that front, and you can reach her at logo@openstack.org. And finally, I'm sure many of you know, for the OpenStack Summit, since we're a major event production, we work with F and Tech. But Kelly Gatelli is our sponsor contact there, but we're usually the primary contact on the. And finally, just some different working groups that have sprung up over the last year that have been really making traction and I think are a really important part of this community and I'd love to see grow this year. So I just wanted to kind of make people aware and figure out how we get more people involved. The first one is the analyst relations team. And what this team has been doing, it's been primarily, I'd say, a group of 5 to 8 kind of internal AR professionals at different companies who have been involved in these calls. And they've really been kind of advising and also helping with our efforts to coordinate the different analyst days that we host at each summit. They've been helping kind of just, you know, share intel as we're talking to different analysts about what they're thinking and any upcoming reports they might have, as well as when we get, we often get reports for like factual review, and we'll pass them around to this team to get their input as well. So if you're interested in being a part of this, definitely love to get you involved and get you plugged into the meetings. I'm not sure when the next meeting is going to be, but we'll definitely promote it to the marketing mailing list and make sure everyone has the information. I probably should have mentioned with our team earlier, many of you may have worked with Margie Callard, and she's actually taking on a new role and will be leaving the foundation. Friday is her last day, so we will miss her, and we're hiring. So she has been leading this analyst relations group, which has really been a great group. She also was leading the content team. So we're, you know, just full disclosure, we're a little bit shaky right now in terms of driving those teams forward. But Robert and I will definitely be point on the analyst relations front. And then the content team, we need to figure out how to kind of pick that back up and get some more involvement in it this year. So. Anyway, that's a quick overview of the analyst relations. For the content team, we tried to put together a process in terms of collaborating around content development in Google Docs and with some biweekly team meetings. And you know, we got a lot of ideas about different content that people would like to see, but we unfortunately didn't make a whole lot of traction in terms of developing content within that team. So I think that we need to look at how we structured it and figured out a way that we can encourage more collaboration and contribution there. So if you have thoughts around it, if you're interested in getting involved, we'll probably kind of suspend some of the meetings for a little while we look to make a content hire and figure out who's going to drive this team forward. But we're interested in picking it back up. Many of you may have heard of the Win the Enterprise team. The marketing business team, which is most relevant to this group, has weekly meetings, and you can find more information at the wiki link. There's really some great participation on that team, and they have some big goals for this year in terms of some content to build out, and as well as right now, I think, working with different enterprise applications on top of OpenStack. So if you're interested in getting involved, it's a really great group, and I definitely encourage you to take a look at the wiki and get involved in those weekly meetings. And similarly, there's some different working groups that might be of interest to you or your organization. There's a telco working group, which also covers NFE, and I believe they meet weekly on Wednesdays. I don't have all the information here. And then there's an application ecosystem working group that that formed up, I guess, in September, October of last year. But I know that Tom Seifel from our foundation staff, as well as Chris Kemp at Nebula, had been working to get that off the ground, and Tom is currently really looking for active participants and volunteers to help with that reference app and documentation. So. Those are some different community working groups. Just want you all to be aware, and we're hiring at the foundation. Shameless promotion. We're hiring a marketing and content manager. We're hiring a membership sponsor account manager, which is a new role for us. Heidi Brett, you may know, is hiring an ecosystem manager to help support her biz dev efforts. We're also hiring another community manager that's more focused on the app dev side, and then we're currently interviewing a couple of different marketing interns. So please help us promote these positions, and we'd love to make some good hires this year. So that's all that I have to share today. I know it was kind of long. I appreciate everyone for participating and listening. I'm going to take it off mute or... feel free
you are now unmuted.
If you have any other questions or feedback.
Hey, this is Derek from Intel. I've got a couple of questions. Maybe lead with one around, you know, we're involved with the Win the Enterprise marketing team. or at least I should say my team is, from a pure marketing sort of coordination perspective. The telco working group, is there any talk about kicking off a similar sort of marketing slash business track or stream there?
I'm actually not sure, Derek. I know that I think that Carol was actually working with Steve Gordon, who had kind of gotten that original NSD group off the ground that transitioned into a telco group. I have not attended any of those meetings, so I'm not sure how it's structured, but it's a good question.
Okay, yeah, I'll check in with Carol. I mean, we sit almost next to each other. Another quick question was these OpenStack days. Haven't taken part. How are these different than, say, you know, the mid-cycle meetups, which are very engineering sort of coordination and community, you know, working sessions, I believe, and then like local meetups in any city, you know, under meetup.com, right? How are these OpenStack days profiled?
Yeah, that's a great question. So I'd say the main difference from like mid-cycle meetups is, you're right, there's not the engineering focus. It's not a design summit. This is more of, you know, promoting OpenStack, sharing what's happening in the project. I would say typically the primary audience is, you know, users, potential users, companies might want to build products around OpenStack. So it's kind of like the more higher level conference type profile. Oftentimes, you know, and these kind of started organically, but oftentimes it's, you know, a local user group may meet monthly or every other month and, you know, have like 50 people come out for a beer and a talk in the evening. And they take that and usually like once a year they might do kind of a bigger event where they're really trying to attract a few hundred people, bring in some higher level folks, attract potential users. And then it really kind of depends on the organizer and the region in terms of like what the exact focus is or the agenda is or, you know, the profile that they're going for. So they kind of vary a little bit. But overall, the OpenStack days either have kind of, I would say, a regional focus, or they might have like kind of a vertical or a specific audience. So they're a little more like targeted, if that makes sense.
Okay, and you've got a calendar where it's, you land in one geo and do a day, and then you're done. It's not a recurring thing in that environment. That's up to the local communities.
Yeah. So oftentimes, you know, a local organizer will approach us and say, hey, we want to put together this event, you know, in Paris and at this time. And then we'll work with them in terms of making sure we can get other folks in the community involved in planning it, making sure that all the sponsorship and speaking is public and that it can kind of meet our standards to be branded as an OpenStack event. But, you know, the majority of organization and coordination is with that local point of contact. And like I said, the ones that have like got it and been successful usually do it about once a year.
Okay.
Yeah. We try to coordinate with them if they want the foundation to come speak so that we can line them up to hit a full event. So like in June, we have a tour that's across Europe, and then next week we'll be in Asia for two different events. And, you know, we ask the two different groups to coordinate their dates together so that we could hit both.
Okay, makes sense. I have one more question, but I'll pause for anyone else.
This is Terry Schlosser. I'm from Rackspace, and I have one question. It is the fifth year for the OpenStack, and I'm just wondering if you guys are planning anything special for celebrating that.
That's a great question. yes, I think that we're interested in kind of going big this year and then maybe scaling back next year and waiting until the 10th anniversary or something. We probably will do another event at OpCon, and we'll probably support the kind of global birthday parties again with the different user groups and put together some content for that. But we're totally open to brainstorming some ideas, something unique and creative if anyone wants to come up with some ideas or get involved this year. Yeah, it's in July, so we usually try to make that month, the birthday month.
Okay, is there a person on your team that's going to focus on that? I'd be happy to work with them and, you know, brainstorm different ideas.
Yeah, contact Claire.
Okay.
Or feel free to send it out to the marketing mailing list as well if you want to get a conversation going. Either way.
Okay, thank you.
Do you have another question
there? Sure. So with all the different groups, there's a Win the Enterprise group, there's a telco group, there's the application ecosystem working group. If these would have similar marketing teams, if you will, marketing or business teams as the enterprise one, is there a need for the content, a specific content team?
There may not be. I mean, I feel like the only group that's focused on content right now outside of that is the Win the Enterprise, so there may not be a separate content team, but I don't think that like everything that we're working on from a content perspective falls under what the Win the Enterprise team is working on right now. But yeah, I mean, that's a good question.
Yeah, that's where if we can get similar, you know, if there's a group of people interested in a similar segment like telco or the application side, you know, if we can try to replicate that Win the Enterprise model, it's probably not a bad idea.
That might be a better way to go about it. We're struggling with the more specific groups.
You are now muted.
Upcoming summit deadlines. We have the contract going live tomorrow, and then the call for speakers is February 9th. So please be thinking about and working on your submissions, and look forward to talking to all of you soon. Thanks. Bye.